Okay, so regulatory authorities. What is the regulatory authority? That act as a connection between the that means drug development department to finalize the marketing department of that company. So in India we have two drug regulatory authority. First one is CDSCO. CDSCO, that is Central Drug Standard Control Organization. Another one is Drug Control General of India, that is Drug Control General of India. So these two are the regulatory authorities which act inside India. And in US there is Food Drug and Administration Department. In US there is Food Drug and Administration Department. Likewise, in other country like Australia, there is Therapeutic Goods Administration Department. In South Africa, there is Medicines Control Council. So, in other country, other regulatory bodies are there, right? Then coming to the role of Regulatory Affairs Department. What is the role? What is the role played by the Regulatory Affairs Department? So, what is this role? It mainly keeps record of each and every single incident starting from the development of the drug to the commercialization of the drug. That means they all keep records of each and everything. Then besides this, they also remain in contact with that Food, Drug and Administration Department, because it is the only department or it is the main boss which gives permission for or which gives approval for the marketing of the drug or sale of the drug, right? Then responsibilities of the, what are the responsibilities? What is the responsibilities? Responsibilities of regulatory affair personnel. So first thing is that as it is a lengthy and complex process of drug development, in each and every stage we need the regulatory department. So first thing is that it keeps in touch with various international legislation. That means in which country we want to market our drug, that regulatory department always thinks in mind that in that country these regulations are there, so we have to follow that kind of regulation. Second one is keep up to date with the various product range. That means suppose paracetamol, we are marketing with paracetamol tablet, but we want to market paracetamol in liquid dosage form, that means in syrup form. So want to market our drug in US. So in US, what is the legislation or what is the rules to market paracetamol in liquid dosage form? So that will be different. So that regulatory affairs department keep a record of that also. Then second thing is coordinate prepare and review a strategy for the drug development inside the drug development organization. That means the drug development should be within a plan. And inside that drug development of, department or drug development organization of a company, various personals are included, like analytical chemist, pharmacologist, physicians. So they keep in touch or keeping records of all these personals or all the activities of that personals. So in a nutshell, I will just end up it. Okay. They monitor the process of all registration submission. So starting from the synthesis in the drug development department to the market, we need two things. Okay, first thing is that investigational new drug, that is IND, and that is investigational new drug, and that is another is the application for drug approval for market. So first is the IND. So it is investigational new drug. It is a submission form, what is an application form, which is submitted to the FDA to do clinical trials. Okay, so first you are doing all the research in the lab, then coming to clinical trials. Okay, you are testing your drugs in human beings. So this is IND is regarding that. Then finally you are applying NDA, that is new drug application. NDA, new drug application. New drug application is for marketing of the drug. So you need approval from the FDA to market the drug, and that form or that application form is called as NDA. So within 180 days, the FDA will approach you with a decision whether your drug is complied with all the safety data or all the efficacy data, or having good laboratory practices you have mentioned, all that is according to compliance or not. So in a nutshell, that was all about the regulatory affair. What do you mean by regulatory affair, as I have discussed? Then what are its role, why it is important, what are the regulatory bodies or what are the regulatory authorities, and what is the responsibilities of a regulatory person. Hope all you understand, or I make you understand, or I am able to make you understand this topic. And thank you everyone. Thank you all.